Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. This is the third video in a series about this telescope, the Skywatcher Heritage 130P, which is also sold as the AWB OneSky. Now in the first videos we concluded that it's great value for money and it would make a great telescope to get started in astronomy with. Now, in the UK it sells for under £150 and in the US it's under $200. So if we're going to make any improvements to it, we need to do that considering our initial outlay. So the idea of this video is to make a couple of budget improvements. We're not going to spend much cash and we're going to try to improve the telescope a little bit. So modification number one is to introduce a light shroud. What's that? Well, it's one of these. So if we go back to the basic telescope, when it's delivered, you recall it looks like this. It's a truss tube Dobsonian, which means that these parts here result in the front of the tube being open. Now normally this isn't a real problem. We're using the scope at night and this design works very well and it allows you to shrink the telescope down to a small size for storage. But what you can find is because this part of the tube is open, then you can experience stray light if you've got maybe a neighbour with a security light close to where you're observing, or more importantly you can have problems where you get condensation onto the exposed secondary mirror. Now, mirrors, they're really magnets for condensation. They get cold, and if you use a telescope outside for not very long really, especially during the winter months, then the condensation can spoil your view. So the idea is to produce a cover or a shroud for the front of the telescope, and the main benefit is going to be to reduce the susceptibility of the telescope to dew, but it'll have an extra benefit of reducing the effect of stray light. So how do we make a shroud for the scope? Well, I went down to a local craft store and I bought a few sheets of this. Now, this is very lightweight, it's 2mm thick foam sheets. They sell it in A3 and A4 sizes, so I picked up a few A3 sheets like this. Now in the UK these cost £1 each, so hopefully you can see straight away we're not looking to spend much money. So one of those sheets isn't quite enough to go all the way around the outside of the tube, but at this price you can easily pick up a few and experiment. So that's what I did. Initially I made a shroud that went all the way around the outside of the tube, and it involved sticking a couple of sheets of the foam together and cutting out a couple of shapes here to allow you to use the focuser and to go around the red dot finder. Now with this arrangement, the shroud goes around the outside and is attached. I've just put a bit of Velcro onto the edge so that you get this sort of effect, and it basically works, but it's not very pretty, and secondly you've got to take it on and off every time you want to put the scope away if you want to shrink it back down to its smallest size. So there's a better solution, and that's to produce a light shroud that fits inside the tube. So this is it. Again, I've used two sheets of the A3. It's actually really about a 1¼ sheet you need. And I've made a cutout for the focuser and a little one here for the secondary vane, and that's really it. And I've got some Velcro on the edges, as you can see here. So all we're going to do is roll up the tube and then put it inside the main tube of the telescope and then feed it forward as we unroll it some more, and then on the front of the tube line up the cutouts that we've made for the focuser and the secondary vane, line them up, and I've put a couple of bits of Velcro on to secure it like so. And then the acid test really is to see whether we can open and close the shroud. So there you go. Nothing snagging. All seems quite secure. And if I turn it round, hopefully you can see that it's quite an effective shield. Obviously you've got a hole where you've got to let the light come out from the secondary mirror to the eyepiece, which is here, but generally it's cut off a lot of the sources of stray light, and it should improve the tolerance of the scope to dew. So it's cost us all of about £2, with maybe another pound or so wastage for the first version that didn't make the cut, but it's a very cheap way of improving the telescope. Okay, so the second modification is to the focuser. Now you might recall that this is a slightly unusual design. It's called a helical focuser, and as you turn the focuser, the eyepiece moves in and out on some threads. Now, a lot of talk about improving this, whether you could replace the focuser entirely with a more conventional rack and pinion arrangement, or whether you could whether the tube is strong enough to take any weight for something like that. And I say don't bother. For the price of this scope, you've got to bear in mind that nothing's perfect, so you want to look to make whatever improvement you can make with a minor investment. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to reduce some of the play that you get in this mechanism. So what do I mean? Well, if you're focusing on an object that's quite close to the telescope, maybe during terrestrial observing, then you'll notice that the eyepiece is going to reach focus quite a long way outside the tube like this. So then the eyepiece rocks on those threads. So we're going to try to improve that. So all we're going to do is we're going to get a roll of PTFE or plumber's tape, and we're going to wrap that around the threads of the focuser. So the idea being that the tape will go inside the threads like so, and it will take up some of the play that's inside the mechanism. So when we finish, we're going to put the focuser back inside the tube, and we're going to tighten it down, and straight away you can feel that there's less play as you might expect. And then if you give it a few turns just to bed it in like so, then let's see how it compares. So we take an eyepiece, put it into the focuser, and we put it in a similar sort of position that we had before, and clearly the side-to-side play is quite reduced. So definitely a little bit of tape like this can improve this part of focuser movement. So that's it, a couple of simple mods for hardly any money. We started with a good telescope and we made it just that little bit better. I hope it's been useful. If you'd like to see more astro videos from the Jenhams Astro YouTube channel, please press the red subscribe button. And thanks for watching.